chemicals to get the best production performance. The quality of the raw ingredients and the smart formulation are essential to provide both nutritional value and health support. But just as important is the process through which the feed is created. In the case of feed pellets, it is essential that the process maintains the quality of the ingredients, preserves the benefits sought by formulation, and optimizes production costs for everyone. How then is a pellet created? And how do you make sure the process delivers the best value to your animals? The first step is selecting the right ingredients. Raw ingredients such as grain, protein sources, and minerals are sourced and delivered to the feed mill in bulk or bags. The raw materials pass through the cleaners, such as magnets and sieves, to remove physical impurities, such as wood, stone, metals, and other foreign objects. Next, the ingredients are passed through a hammer mill or roller mill and ground to reduce particle size, decrease segregation, increase pellet quality, and increase their surface area to allow better nutrient digestibility. The ingredients are then mixed in the correct proportion to create a balanced feed according with the formula. The mixing process ensures that the different raw materials are evenly distributed in the feed and that the final product has the right nutritional content. Adding surf aids in the mixer improves the conditioning and pelleting process. Bear in mind that conditioning is a crucial step of preparing for pelleting. Conditioning involves adding heat and moisture to the feed. This increases their ability to bind together during the pelleting process, helping form pellets of the desired size and density. Conditioning also changes the physical and chemical characteristics of protein and carbohydrates, making them easier to digest once they reach the gastrointestinal tract of animals. The addition of heat and surface can also help to reduce the presence of harmful microorganisms, such as bacteria and fungi, that may be present in the feed ingredients. This can improve the safety and quality of the feed. Surface also ensures that the pellet maintains an optimal degree of moisture, that the process is highly energy efficient, and that the life of the dye is preserved as much as possible. And now, the pellet mill, the heart of the feed pellet manufacturing process. It consists of a die and rollers that compress the moist, heated mash into small, compact shapes. The die has small holes or orifices that determine the diameter of the pellets. After the pellets are formed, they are quite hot and moist, so they are sent through a cooling system to reduce their temperature and moisture. This also helps to ensure that the pellets are stable and won't crumble during transportation or storage, and also to ensure their microbial quality during its shelf life. The cooled pellets are afterwards sent through a sifter to separate fine and oversized pellets. Once the pellets are cooled and separated, they are ready to be packaged. They are sent out bulk or loaded into bags, which are then sealed and labeled with information about the nutritional content, feeding instructions, expiry date, and other important information about the feed and manufacturer. And that's it. The finished feed pellets are loaded onto a truck and shipped to meet their end users, the animals. The process requires specialized equipment and skilled personnel to ensure that the final product is of high quality and meets the nutritional requirements of the animals. Critical additives such as surface optimize the cost and quality for feed mills and ensure maximum value in the final product to serve animal producers.